Hello, hello.
Hello.
Hello, who are you?
I'm Elena.
I'm Patrick.
And we're tennis.
This is the first time we've had breakfast.
In a week, so we're very happy.
When you got together, did you decide what sound tennis would be, or did it just sort of slowly happen?
I mean, for Keep Joy, we really wanted to channel, like, girl group aesthetic, like 50s, 60s pop. We felt like that suited the story we were telling. But it was actually really fun with young and old to kind of distance ourselves from something that we worked really hard to figure out how to do with our first album and kind of open the door and let in a more diverse array of influences, because we listened to way more music than just that. It's just that that was our goal for our first record. With young and old, we had no like particular goal in mind.
Yeah.
It was kind of a liberating experience. Often Patrick will start off writing a bit of the music to a song. He'll write some chord progressions, and I'll start with an idea or a theme that I feel like would suit the song, and I'll kind of pitch it to him and be like, you know, what do you think? And like, yes or no, and then kind of go from there. So he's definitely my sounding board.
Do you decide when you're going to switch off being a band and be an official couple?
I wish we could do it more easily, but sometimes it gets blurry.
Yeah.
It's really hard to switch off between being a band and being in a relationship.
Yeah, it's hard, especially when you're on tour. You're kind of on all the time, I guess. It's always work. I mean, you never just go home and go to bed. I mean, you're like getting to a hotel and preparing for the next show. And so it is really, really hard to separate our personal life from the band. And it's something that we struggle with all the time.
And do you this full time? Can you afford? And so, how do you feel the state of the music industry at the moment? That like 10 years ago, you potentially would have been making more money.
Yeah.
If you were around.
It was a little depressing, but then again, I don't think 10 years ago we would have been able to do this.
Yeah, 10 years ago we would never have become a band. I guess we maybe would have made more money, but I don't think we would have existed.
Yeah, like garage band didn't exist 10 years ago.
And I don't think log buzz bands existed 10 years ago.
Yeah, there was much more.
Yeah,
yeah,
I mean, you needed to be like discovered by, you know, the A&R department of a major label.
Yeah.
That's not what happened to us
all.
You know, people wrote about us from the comfort of their own homes while we had never ventured out to play a show in our lives. So as much as, I mean, for example, Young and Old has already leaked and has been illegally downloaded thousands of times. That's money we'll never make, but at the same time, we would never have been able to make that album if it wasn't for the internet's own momentum.
Do you ever download music illegally?
Yeah. Especially when it's like, people do it to me, I'll do it to you, and it feels fair.
We do have kind of like a criteria for illegally downloading though, and that is if we like it, we're supporting it somewhere or another. We don't like download something, love it, and then never support the band.
Well, a small part of me kind of feels like MP3s should be free, because it's nothing. It's just, yeah, they're like a really degraded form anyway. They're like the lowest quality version of the songs. And then it's just digital data. I mean, who wants to pay for that?
Yeah.
I want to pay for that. I would pay for a vinyl or to see a concert. I mean, you want to, if money is changing hands, you want something real that you can hold. You don't want just like,
it's like a service.
Yeah, I know. It feels like it should be free, and it kind of is right now.
Do you prefer to play club shows or festivals, or how does your sound come across better?
I think clubs are better. You have a little more control. You get a proper sound check and time. Festivals are really...
It depends. I don't know. Most of them can be really daunting, but occasionally one or two festivals will be.
But in general, festivals are really hectic. Like, you're in a tent and you just run on stage and just plug in and go.
Yeah.
You have no idea what you're hearing.
Do you get to sound check at all at a festival?
No, not usually. I mean, big bands do. Headliners get sound check.
One day.
We just get corralled onto the stage and turn on.
Yeah. Well, it was lovely chatting to you, and I look forward to seeing you live.